Hello there, everyone. I've been studying some for the benchmark exams. Working on the benchmark that reads, "Explain how America reacted to a changing society by examining issues associated with the Red Scare, Prohibition, the Scopes Trial, the changing role of women and African Americans, the Ku Klux Klan, the Palmer Raids, the National Origins Act, and restrictions on immigration." Right after the end of World War I, there was the Red Scare in the United States. Communists had taken over Russia. Americans worried about whether Russians who had come to the United States were radicals that would try to take over the United States. The labor unrest immediately after the war increased the concern that radicals were trying to overthrow the government. But it was the bombing of Wall Street and of Attorney General A. Mitchell Palmer's home that convinced many Americans there was something sinister afoot. Attorney General Palmer started a series of raids on the homes and apartments of suspected radicals. They were called the Palmer Raids. They netted a few people who were shipped back to the Soviet Union. People's civil rights and civil liberties were often trampled and ignored in the search for the communist foreigners in our midst. Most of all, the Palmer Raids stirred up fear of foreigners and especially of immigrants. Americans demanded an end to these radical immigrants coming to the United States. The Congress responded. It passed the National Origins Act. This law greatly reduced the number of people allowed to immigrate to the United States. It especially stopped large numbers of immigrants from East Europe and Italy from coming to the United States. During the 1920s, Americans did not like foreigners or persons they thought of as foreigners. The second Ku Klux Klan members didn't like anybody but themselves. The Klan continued to target African Americans for acts of hate and terror. It added to its list of un-Americans Roman Catholics, Jews, Union members, communists, and foreigners. They too were targeted for hate, vandalism, and acts of terror. The Klan became very powerful in the nation during the first half of the 1920s. It controlled the government of several states and the government of several cities. Lawlessness increased during the 1920s. Much of the lawlessness was the result of prohibition, the banning of alcoholic beverages. Americans wanted booze and they continued to get it from illegal sources. Organized crime associated with the mafia started up big time during prohibition. Mobsters provided illegal booze and killed each other and innocent civilians defending or expanding their illegal alcohol empires. Al Capone, in Chicago, was the most famous of the mobsters. He was far from alone in spreading terror in the streets and corruption though city and local government. The Scopes trial was the infamous monkey trial in Tennessee over teaching Darwin's theory of evolution. Tennessee passed a law making it illegal to teach the ideal of evolution in the state's public schools. John Scopes taught it anyway. He was taken to court and found guilty. The law and the guilty plea pleased many fundamentalist Protestant Christians who believed evolution was irreligious because it contradicted what they believed was said in the Bible. Success at the Scopes trial was another success for the rural traditional values culture that was fighting the growing new culture in American cities. In spite of all these things, the Great Migration continued in the 1920s. African Americans continued to move from the South to the cities of the North in search of a better life. They hoped for jobs in the factories of the North, an escape from the harshest conditions of Jim Crow laws in the South. After World War I, African Americans found it harder to find factory jobs in the North. The positions were being given to white soldiers returning from the war in Europe. During the 1920s, prosperity seldom found its way into African American homes. African Americans continued to have much higher unemployment, work much lower paid jobs, and live in the worst sections of the ever-growing American cities. Just the same, African Americans were responsible for one of the greatest cultural periods in America during the 1920s, the Harlem Renaissance. The North was unforgiving for African Americans, but still better than life in the South. I got to go. Before I do, Let's list the important things to remember. The Red Scare led to deportations and limitations on immigration to the United States. The Red Scare also led to a disregard for Americans' civil liberties and their civil rights. It created public fear of certain groups of people. Prohibition led Americans to have less respect for the law. It also led to organized crime, which specialized in providing illegal booze. For African Americans, the Great Migration continued. African Americans from the rural South moved in large numbers to the urban North in search of well-paying jobs and a better life. They did not escape segregation. They did escape some of the worst aspects of Jim Crow laws. For now, I'm out of here. Think about what we've talked about and how it might end up as questions on your benchmark exam.